Hello, Bulldogs. This is a tutorial to basically sum up our final project. Each of y'all are responsible for one of the applications down here below, and you need to do one requirement. I'm going to start with Photoshop. For Photoshop, you were supposed to get a virtual prop. It is a news desk, and put your news logo right here. Actually, not the logo, but at least the call letters. Okay, to do this, all I did is I went to the web. I typed in news desk. Once I typed in news desk, I searched through. You want to make sure that you find one that is not, two, three dimensional like this one, or this one right here that's at an angle wouldn't be good. Okay, I went ahead and picked one that was kind of straightforward like this one right here. Remember, when you click on it, you simply right click, save image as, and save it to your folder. Once it's in your folder, you open it up in Photoshop by clicking on file open. Okay, here it is right here, and I open it in my application. I'm going to go ahead and make a copy of the background. I'm going to click on my move tool, and this is how I move this to the other spot. Once it's on the other spot, as you can see, I did some stretching. I wanted to make sure it was a background of 1920 by 1080, so I went file new, and I started with the canvas of 1920 by 1080, and I clicked OK. Moved my desk on top. As you can see, I stretched it a little bit, used the text tool, typed BBNN, chose a style for text, and that's it. Okay, when you're finished with this, you click File, Save As. You choose Ping as the file type. That will keep your background transparent and save it to your folder. Okay, for Photoshop, that is all you need to do. For the next program, Illustrator. In Illustrator, you're supposed to create a logo. To create a news logo, basically what you do is you go File, New. When it first opens up, you really don't have to change anything here. You just click OK. And once it opens up like so, if you do not want your white background, hold down Control, Shift, and the letter D. Your background will turn transparent. Use your shape tools. I'm going to use a rounded ellipse. Okay, if you want to change the fill to that, you can do it right here. If you want to change the stroke width, the stroke color, you can do it here. Stroke width, I'm going to change to a lot bigger. And then I'm just going to make myself a little news logo. If you want to type in the middle of that, click your text tool. Here's where you're going to type your call letters. You may want to highlight those and make those a lot bigger than that. I'm going to make it about 175. If you want to change the font color, you could do that right here. And if you wanted a stroke on that, you could do it here. Okay, I'm just going to keep it kind of plain for time purposes. When you're ready to export this, just like in Photoshop, you're going to go File, Export, and you're going to make sure you save it as a ping. Okay, call it something different than untitled, and you will turn it in. As you can see, I've made several there. Okay, that is all you need to do for Illustrator. For After Effects, I'm not going to spend much time on this one because we've actually just finished this one, so you should be pretty familiar with it. All I did is I made myself the BBNN by typing right here, and then I added one of the preset effects. Okay. Remember the preset effects, to apply them, all you do is drag them straight on to the composition. I'm going to click the drop down arrow. I'm going to specifically choose text effects, and I just picked one of these. I think I did an animate in, and I dragged it onto the desktop. And then I also added who's in my news team, which in this particular situation is just me. I just did a fade in and out. So a very quick BBNN with a fade out, and then who is on my news team. You may want to remember, you want to make that just a few seconds, because the audition sound effect that whoever is doing audition will do will match for that little intro. Okay. When you're finished with this one, you just go File, Export, Add to Adobe Media Encoder. Remember to choose the MP4. Okay. We did that just a while back, so that should be pretty simple. Next one is Audition. In Audition, I did a little bit of pre-recording. I had Sweet Caroline record a little sound effect. Once I had that done, I added the echo effect. You guys should remember how to do that. You just click on whatever effect you want to add. I added reverb. Once you have that done, I went and got a sound effect. Remember to get sound effects. You go to your news channel. You click on Creator Studio. Once you click on Creator Studio, over here to the left, you'll see Create. You'll see an audio library. I don't want songs. I want sound effects. And then just type in whatever you want. I think I typed in chime. And you'll get some results. Just listen to them and see if they're, if you like them. Okay, once you find one you like, you click the download button. You'll see it download right over here to my left. To get it into your folder, collapse the menu and simply drag it to the desktop. Eventually, you can drag that straight into your folder. That's how you get the sound. We open up Audition. And now we're ready for a multi-track session. I imported my sound by clicking on File, Import, File. Okay, once I did that, here's my magic chime. Okay, now I just open a multi-track session. I just dragged down my sound clip that Caroline recorded, and then my sound effect at the end. Put them together. Remember that if I wanted to increase the volume of this one, I could adjust it here. If I wanted it to be a little bit louder on the voice, I could do that here. Okay, when you're finished with this one, File, Export, Multi-track mixdown, entire session. Remember, when you do that, you save it as an MP3. Browse to your folder. That's all you do on that one. And last but not least, animate. We did animate a while back, but you might remember all you basically do is you make your canvas, File, New, make sure it's 1920 by 1080. All I did was type BB and N, made the alternating colors, then inserted a frame a little bit further over and changed the colors. So here I changed this to black and this to black and then this to red and then this to red so that if you come up here, all I had was it switching colors. Then I just highlighted these frames and pasted and pasted and pasted and pasted all the way down here. You want to make this animation about 10 seconds long because if you don't, when you export it, you're going to have to drag, when we pull it into Premiere, if it was only 1 second long, you're going to have to pull it down to the timeline about 100 times. So instead, make it about 10 seconds long. Notice that mine's about 9.8. Okay, when you're ready, click on File, Export, Movie. We're going to export it as an animated GIF. Okay, save it into your folder. Make sure it's in your Premiere folder. Everything should be saved in your Premiere Final Project folder. Click Save. Make sure everything stays the same here. Click OK. And it exports that. That is how you do all five. So what you should do today to start with is you should watch this video. Once you're done watching the video, figure out which one you are responsible for and knock it out. That is all